Welcome. In this tutorial, we will look at how to build a project from scratch and install Xero's PHP OAuth 2 SDK using Composer. Now, I'm going to assume that you actually have Composer up and running. We can fire up our terminal and just double check that. So I'm going to put in Composer version. And we can see, yes, I have Composer and the version I'm running. It's all good. So what we'll want to do is also let you know that we are running a local server. We're running MAMP. You might be running something different depending on your operating system. But inside of MAMP, we have a folder called htdocs, and that's where all of our files will live that we can access through a browser. So let's change into that directory. Applications, MAMP, htdocs. And inside of here, I've got different folders for different projects. I'm going to create a new folder called my app2, and then I'm going to change into the my app2 folder, and there's nothing in there. So I'm going to make this a little bit bigger so you can see. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually run a Composer command to set up my package manager. So Composer init. So this is going to kick off an interactive thing where it actually asks me questions. But you'll see it actually already tells me that if I just hit enter, it'll accept sid.maestri/myapp2 as my package name. So that looks good. I'll hit enter. I don't need a description. I could put one in. I'm going to hit enter. That's the author. Sure, we'll accept that. Minimum stability. Just going to go ahead and hit enter. This is, you know, we're trying to just do the minimum here. I'm going to say this is a project for my package type. License, I'm going to leave that blank. Now here's real important. It says, do you want to define your dependencies interactively? I'm going to say no. And then it says, do I want to define my dev dependencies interactively? And I'm going to say no as well. So now it's ready. It's telling me this is what we're going to generate as your Composer file, your package definition. And I'm going to say yes. And there it is. It's been created. And if I say list, I can see there is my composer.json file. So why don't I, I'm using VS Code. So I have a shortcut here that I've enabled. So I can just type in code composer.json from the terminal, and it will actually open up my Composer file here inside of my VS Code here. Now, we don't have anything required here. So that's where I want to go back to my browser. And I want to look in here, and I'll see that I have my require example here for using my OAuth 2 library. Now, you might have other libraries you want to require, but for this basic tutorial, I'm just going to paste that in there. And of course, if there's a different version you want to specify, you can do that as well. I'll hit save. And now if I go back to my terminal, I can type in composer install. And what it's doing now is it's reading, it's going in, it's reading not just my OAuth 2 library dependency, but all the libraries that that has included inside of a Composer file inside of my library. So you can see it downloads some additional libraries that we need. And if I do a list, I can see I now have a folder called vendor. And if I went and looked inside of vendor, I'd see a lot of different libraries that were downloaded automatically for me for my project. So let me jump back over to VS Code. And I want to create a new file. And this is going to be my index file. So let's put a little HTML in here. Just the bare bones here. See if I can get that spelled right. And I just want to put a link here to my first page. Now, the first page we're going to link to, I've called authorization.php, and this is going to say connect to Xero. Now, I need to save this. I'm going to call it index.php, save it, cool. And if I go to my browser, because I'm used to using MAMP, I know that MAMP runs everything on 8888 port. And I know if I point to my app2 and hit load. Oh, I do not have my, gotta make sure I have, there we go. Gotta close off my href tag. So there, if I click that, it's gonna go to a page that doesn't exist yet. Now, where are we gonna get the code for this authorization.php? Well, it's right here in the GitHub repository. We have a bare bones example of our OAuth flow. And that's what we're gonna use today. I'm gonna actually grab, I'm gonna copy this code right here. I'm gonna copy it. I'm gonna go back to VS Code. I'm gonna do a file, new file. I'll paste my code in, do a command S to save it, and I'll call it authorization.php. And you can see I'm saving it in the same myapp2 directory. So let's go ahead and save that. And I'm going to need a few more files. I'm going to need a callback PHP. So I've got all that code here ready for you. So I'm just going to go ahead and copy that. Come back to my project, do a command N, create a new file, paste it, command S to save it. Let's call it callback.php, save it. And there's two more files. Now, this third file here is called storage.php. This is not something that you're probably going to use in a production app. This is just saving information like your access token into a session variable. You'll want to persist this into a real database, but we're just doing a demo here. And I don't want to have to spin up a database or force you to do the same. So let's just create a new file here and we'll paste our code. And we'll hit save and call it storage.php. Save that. And our fourth and final file is called authorized resource.php. So now this is once we've got all the bits and pieces we need, our access token, our Xero tenant ID, we can actually go and call an endpoint and get some data back. And in this case, we're going to call the organization endpoint and get back some data. So I'm going to copy that and I'll create my fourth file, paste it, hit save and call it authorized resource.php. Hopefully I'm spelling all these files correctly. Now you might think, cool, we're ready to start, but before we can do anything, you'll see we've got some values we need to populate. One is the client ID, the next is the secret, and then we also need to fix our path here because our redirect URI or our callback URL has to point back to our local server to myapp2. So that's the correct callback. Now, where do I get my client ID and secret? Well, I'm going to get those from Xero. So I need to go to Xero. If I'm in developer.xero.com, there is a menu item called My Apps. And if I'm logged into Xero, I can click it. If I'm not logged in, it'll ask me to log in. And I go over to this button here for OAuth2, and I click that to create a new OAuth2 app. And I'm going to call this PHP from scratch. I'm going to give my company URL and my privacy policy URL. And most importantly, I'm going to need a redirect URL, which will be HTTP, no S, because I'm running this locally. I don't have that set up. Localhost colon 888 forward slash my, oh, sorry, 48 forward slash my app2 forward slash callback.php. So that looks good. That matches my redirect URI here. I'm going to click that I've agreed to the terms and say create my app. There's already an app with that name. Let's give it a different name. Let's go ahead and create it. All right, cool. So now my app has been created and I have a client ID, but no secret yet. So let's go ahead and generate that secret. Now, do not hit save yet, because once you hit save, this client secret goes away and it's hidden forever and you can't get it back. So this is the one opportunity to copy it. So I'm going to copy the ID, go back to my code here, and I'm going to paste it. And here's the thing you need to know is it's not just inside of authorized resource, but we also need to do it in callback. And we need to do it in authorization. Now in your real app, you might store these in like an environmental variable inside of like AWS so that you can just point to this environmental variable that has the client ID and it wouldn't be pasted throughout your code. But again, this is just a demo. We want to be, you know, quick and easy, not make you spin up anything on AWS or Azure or any of those other cloud hosting services. I'm going to copy the secret and I'm going to paste my secret here. Go back through these three files and paste my secret. I'm going to save this. My callback looks good. I'm going to copy that little bit that I changed in my callback. I'll go to the callback one. Need to update my redirect URI there as well. Save that. And finally, in my authorization PHP, I need to update my path for my redirect URI and save it. So make sure all my files are changed and saved. That's all looking good. And now I can hit save inside of Xero. This will secure my secret on Xero. And if I ever need my secret again, I have to actually delete the old one and generate a new secret because I can't ever get access to it again. Now, that's all looking good. So what I'm going to do here is hit refresh, make sure we're good. And if I named all my files correctly, no typos, we should go through an OAuth flow right now. Okay, now this is the consent URL. Now this is not asking me for access to my organization data yet. It's just asking to access my user profile, which is my first step. So I'm going to go ahead and say allow access. And now it's going to ask me, can I connect to your demo company and get access to these different bits of information? And this is all defined through scopes, which are part of OAuth 2. So if I changed my scope, I could ask for more or less endpoint access from the end user. So there's consent here from the end customer. I'm going to go ahead and say connect. And it redirected me back to my callback where I saved my access token and then forwarded me on to the authorized resource.php file. And I just dumped the response from the get organization. So if I go back to my code, authorized URL, you can see I'm just doing a dump here. So let's clean this up just a little bit, make this a little more readable. I'm just going to say echo hello space, and I'm going to go into this object and I'm going to say get organizations. So I'm going to get from the organization object, I'm going to get the first organization in the array that's returned, and from that organization I'm going to say get name. Hit save. Hopefully my PHP code is correct here. And if I go back and hit refresh, ah, darn it. All right, let's reload it. And there we are. Hello, demo company. So just a little typo there. So from your organization endpoint, you can get all kinds of things. You can get the version. Hit reload. This is the US version. So that's how you bare bones get up and running from scratch with Composer and install your SDK and get up and running with PHP.